Murgul doesn't lend coin to outlanders. Look somewhere else.
Let's talk to Fenris. He'll set you up with whatever you need.
You've got so much hope to our people. We are forever in your debt.
A fight! I'm getting out of here.
Veteran's name, I order you to stop. Well, I suppose I could forget that I saw you this time, huh?
Thank you for coming. After everything you've already done for Ravenrock, I hate to ask for more, but I can't risk Councillor Morvain being killed. The Ulan family of House Hlaalu, a rival great house, has placed a death mark on the Councillor's head. It's a private matter. Let's just say they seek revenge for the execution of one of their own, ordered by Councillor Morvain himself. The problem is, I don't have any solid proof that anyone from House Hlaalu is hidden among us. Only my suspicions. Now that's just ridiculous. As second councillor, it's my responsibility to protect Councillor Morvain from harm. I'm afraid that one day I'll awaken and discover him dead. I don't want it to come to that. I do. I've received some information from my sources that there could be elements of Ulan's house, House Hlaalu, already in Ravenrock. Ravenrock is a small settlement, so it's hard to accomplish anything in secret. If any of them is from House Hlaalu, I wouldn't be able to make a move without them knowing. I had a feeling you'd be willing to listen to me. I need you to start out by being my eyes and ears. Search Ravenrock and see if you can root out these traitors. The best place to start would be Geldis Sadri, over at the Retching Netch Corner Club. If he provides you any leads, check them out before bringing them to my attention. I can't afford to make any mistakes. Traitors. The lot of them. Their collaboration with the Empire may have given them unrivaled political and economic strength, but their hearts weren't with the Dunma people. Hlaalu deserved every bit of hatred they received once the Empire released its grasp on Morrowind. Having passed ties to the Empire immediately turned them into the scapegoat for the Dunma people's suffering. They had welcomed the Empire with open arms and benefited from it. When everything was said and done, they were no longer recognized as a great house and were dismissed from the council. You might think it's all perfume and roses now that the mine's open, but all I see is a new security problem on our hands. Making sure those shipments of ebony make it safely from the mine to the shipping docks is my new order of the day. And with Solstheim crawling with Reavers and Azora knows what else, I can't risk any attacks on Ravenrock. I maintain a few contacts in other Dunma settlements across Tamriel. Most hail from House Reruran, but there are a few from other houses. Most of my contacts live leagues away from Solstheim. Sending the occasional message back and forth is all we can manage, and sometimes takes months or more to arrive. However, any information we can glean in times like this, I consider vital to House Reruran's survival. During the Oblivion crisis, gates to the Plain of Oblivion opened all over Morrowind. The Empire pulled most of its forces out of Morrowind to deal with the gates in their own homeland, leaving us virtually defenseless. We had no standing army at the time, just uncoordinated pockets of resistance. House Reruran took charge and was slowly able to build an army. It took years, but it became a force to be reckoned with. When the Argonians invaded years later, House Reruran's army was able to prevent them from sweeping across all of Morrowind. It would be fair to say that House Reruran literally saved the Dunma people from destruction. Don't worry. You can trust Geldis. He's been with us for a long time.
I don't know who... Take a look. Careful with those netches. They may look tame.
Find my pickaxe yet? So, you finally tracked down old Crecius, eh? Quite a character, isn't he? Tell you what, since you went through all the trouble of finding it for me and all, you keep it. I just wanted to remind that codger you can't just go around taking things from other people. Now that you've delivered the message, I'm satisfied. Besides, that pickaxe hasn't done me any good in years. Maybe you can put it to good use. I've always had a steady stream of work thanks to the Reruran Guard, so it hasn't affected me much. However, I've seen the smile on people's faces, and there's hope around here once again. Something we've been lacking for a long time. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage? Bring your weapons and armor to me. I'll fix it up right.
It's busier now that things are starting to look up. I guess I might stay a bit longer after all. Mining gear? No. However, I used to sell East Empire pendants until I ran out of them. Popular little item. It's an amulet that was made exclusively for the East Empire Company. They gave them to their workers as an incentive at one point. A kind of reward for extra effort. They're no longer being made, so they've become a collectible. I'd love to get my hands on a few of them. They could be anywhere on the island. The mines might be a good place to start. If you find any while you're exploring Solstheim, bring them here, and I'll pay you for them. Things are picking up for now. All I'm wondering is how long it'll take for House Redoran to begin ignoring us again if the mine runs out of ore for a second time. Bad. What if I told you that you're the first person that's even considered looking at my wares today? I've half a mind to contact my friends at the East Empire Company and see if they need an extra hand in Windhelm. Oh, absolutely. In fact, I've corresponded with Vittoria Vici herself more than once. You know, the lady who runs the East Empire Company warehouse in Solitude. The biggest warehouse they have in Skyrim. Bah. You're just like the rest of the folks around here. Mark my words. The East Empire Company will return to Ravenrock. And when they do, I'll be at the top of their list. The question you should be asking is, what don't I sell here? Because I have pretty much any supplies you might need. If it's not a weapon, potion, or armor, then it's likely that I have it. Jarland over at the docks brings me most of my supplies, and the rest comes from bartering with the people in town. Oh, Glover Mallory gets me a few things once in a while. He usually has the most amazing deals that I can't pass up. Take a look. Empire pendants are scattered all over, so leave no stone unturned.
I work for Mokrel. You got a problem, you talk to him.
Captain V. Welcome to the Retching Niche Corner Club. Home of the finest Sue Jammer that will ever grace your lips.
How about I just settle for some Maz tea and we'll forget
how are you, Faye? It's a blessing. I've got regular paying customers again. Thirsty workers at the end of the day, and more coin than I can count.
Get away from me.
Well, well. Agil's got himself a spy, does he? Azura knows he needs all the help he can get. He's been chasing the Ulans for years now. No, I just think he's going about this the wrong way. Actually, I do. If you want to catch those slippery slaughterfish, you need to let them come to you. There's an Ulan ancestral tomb near the temple. Someone's been leaving ash yam offerings on the altar inside. If you were to wait inside for whomever that is, I'm betting they'll have some of the answers you're looking for.
What makes you think I have it?
Any time Adril and the Redoran Guard made a move, the Uhlans must have been one step ahead and didn't show up. You can thank me if it works. Until then, I'd head to the tomb and wait until your visitor shows up. I can sense your
concern. It's not
safe travel. The mine's open, people are buying drinks, and back in 95, Vila Uhlan came to Ravenloft with a plan to take over our town. But Fetcher thought he could stir up the locals and use them against the Redoran Guard, and then murder Councillor Morvain when we weren't looking. He arrived alone, but spread enough coin around to start changing people's minds. Half the bloody town joined his side. Can you believe that? He underestimated the Redoran Guard. They were organized and brought a swift end to the coup. Vila tried to run, but he was caught by Captain Veleth himself. Vila Uhlan was executed a short time later, and his remains placed in the Uhlan ancestral tomb. When a Dunmer is laid to rest, the body is burned and returned to the ashen soil. Since the Ashyam is born of the very same soil, it represents rebirth and renewal, the fact that life ends and begins anew. Safe travels, Outlander.
If there's anything at all I can do to help, please let me know. I appreciate the help you've been giving us.
Still here. As you wish, my Thane.
Drayler, I have a message for you.
Tell my father if he wants to speak to me. He should do it in person.
It's not from your father. It's from Captain Veleth.
Oh my goodness. I'm so sorry, Geldis. Please, tell me, what did he say?
One moment. You look...
Excuse me. I didn't realize there was anyone else here. I presume the same thing you're doing, leaving an offering for the departed. Forgive my surprise. It's just that I wouldn't expect that sort of behavior from someone who isn't Dunmer. Since there aren't any Uhlans left on this island, I've taken it upon myself to leave the traditional offering in their stead. What do you mean? I thought I was clear. I'm simply honoring a fellow departed Dunmer. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to meditate a bit.
One moment.
I hope Geldis proved useful. Have you made any progress?
Tell us, Sue.
Are you sure? So Geldis's plan worked, eh? Every time we tried it, no one would ever show up. If Telesul's involved in any sort of plot to harm Councillor Morvane, I'm going to need hard evidence to prove it.
I was just making conversation.
I'm not kicking down anyone's door until I have solid evidence in hand. If you're wrong about Telesul, things would quickly go downhill around here, and the real culprits might slip away. I can't afford for that to happen.
If you use them to
if you have evidence and it places your life in peril, I would expect you to do whatever you must to keep yourself alive. Here, this key should open the front door of the manor in case they've locked it. Good luck. Telesul is wife to the family patriarch Vendel. They have a single child, a daughter named Miri. They arrived here 10 years ago, and have been nothing but a benefit to Raven Rock ever since. They are quite wealthy, and they've been quite generous by sharing their fortune with the community. They've contributed coin, food, supplies, even helped repair a few of the buildings in town with their own hands. People have mentioned it's a bit odd about how close in age Mary appears to be to her father, but that's hardly a cause for alarm. Just make sure you find solid evidence. If I accuse them without it, I'll be the laughing stock of the colony. Be careful. If the Severans have betrayed us, then they'll be well armed. You find any evidence at Severan Manor yet?
Come on.
I trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
Did you find any evidence at Severin Manor yet? Then we finally have them. All that remains now is chasing them down and bringing them to justice.
Good.
I'm going to send two of the best Rereran guard we have to take them down. I want you to assist them any way you can. See that you do. We can't afford to let these traitors slip away. Ashfallow Citadel's been abandoned for a long...
You look familiar.
One moment.
Welcome to the Wretching Netch Corner Club, home of... Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
As you command, my thane.
the somber evening, but we got ourselves ill.
Better than that.
was that?
I knew it!
1 moment.
The mines are open and the shop is busy again.
Were you able to track down Vendel? Out with it. Then, it's finally over. What of the Reren guard I sent to assist you? Damn it. I was hoping to protect our people by sending them, not end up with casualties. To think that Vendel would stoop so low as to hire those fetchers. I'm glad you killed him. Wonderful. Simply wonderful. Councillor Morvane will be quite pleased when he hears about this. Tell us who is wife to the family patriarch, Vendel. They have a single child, a daughter named Miri. They arrived here 10 years ago and have been nothing but a benefit to Raven Rock ever since. They are quite wealthy and they've been quite generous by sharing their fortune with
you. If you're looking to purchase something,
follow me and I'll take you to the councillor so you can speak to him yourself.
One moment. You look familiar. Any trouble? What can I do for you?
You've brought
Councillor Morvane. I have some wonderful news.
Adriel, I haven't seen a smile on your face like that in a long time.
This visitor has single-handedly dealt with a threat that could have ended your life. Vendel, Telesu, and Miri Severin weren't who they appeared to be. I'm afraid they were here to avenge Villa Ulan's death.
Vendel? But he's done so much for Raven Rock. How could this be possible?
They did it to gain our confidence, Counselor. They had us all fooled. I should have been more vigilant. I'm sorry.
Don't say that. It's not your fault, old friend. And you... step forward. What you've done for me, for all of Raven Rock, goes far beyond what I would have expected from a traveler to our town. For this, you have my deepest gratitude. Now, I'm certain Adriel was prepared to reward you appropriately for everything you've done. However, since a bit of coin hardly seems like enough, I've decided to provide something more substantial. Since the Severin family, or whoever they were, turned out to be criminals, their property is now forfeit. As counselor, I hereby award you Severin Manor and everything contained within. You've earned your citizenship here, and I hope you'll consider staying with us as a member of our community.
Thank you enough for reopening the ebony mines. You've brought light to the darkness, my friend.
One moment.
If you're looking for passage, talk to Captain Jarls.
Can't say I'd mind heading out of here. I still need to get paid, of course. Right then. Let's be off.
Hello.
Glad Orthus was able to find someone competent to help out.
We got a nickname for anyone who trifles with us guards here in Windhelm.
I'm so cold. They're dead. My mama died when I was little. I don't remember her very well. My father was a Stormcloak soldier. One day he left and didn't come back. I'm all alone. I try to sell flowers so I can buy food. It's not much, but what else can I do? Really? Do you have a place I could live? Oh, wow. Are you sure? You really wouldn't mind? Yay! Thanks, Mama! I promise I'll be the best daughter ever!
Need a ride? Where do you want to go? Climb and back, and we'll be off. Little snow never stopped me. Don't worry.
still here. I will remain on guard here. We heading out? How can I serve you, my Thane? We heading out? As you command, my Thane.
Hey! Watch it!
Hand over your valuables, or I'll gut you like a fish. Nice try. I'm not going to ask again. Don't you walk away from me!
never should have come here.
Ugh!
where this is going.
Thank you. fools!
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense? All right, all right. Just keep your voice down, and don't let me catch you again.
feeling sick?
My favorite drinking. Not anymore, thanks to you, friend.
Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun. Yorland Greymane's got... Looking to protect yourself? Or deal some damage? Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
Divine smile on you, friend.